Hello, everybody, and welcome to the SWE UPRISING web show with me, Jimmy Young. We have Eddie Devine, and we have John Kerr here on the commentary. We have a great show for you this evening.
You got it right. You actually got it right for once.
Well,
yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Top level commentary here. Top level. And here we go with Ron Corvus coming out.
Who is this guy?
That man.
Ron Corvus.
Ron Corvus.
I've seen this boy in some videos, I've seen what he has to bring, and this boy does not mess about.
Really?
He's not here to play, he's here to win. And I can guarantee it will be a massacre tonight.
I'm going to be honest with you.
But do you know who he's fighting though? Do you know who he's fighting?
No, I don't actually, so it's going to be a very big surprise, but whoever it is, you'll have to have his eyes peeled.
I'm just going to say, this is the first time I've seen Ron Corvus. I haven't seen him before, so let's see if he impresses me.
It's Nathan Reynolds!
Here's Nathan Reynolds!
So I was saying he's going to have to be smart, he's going to have to be ready for his, and have his eyes open. But Nathan Reynolds, he's been in the ring with the Monster Abyss, so he'll be ready for anything.
Yeah, you say he's been in the ring, he's also been outside the ring because it was a monster.
True, he was all around the other with the best, so I'm sure he's not even afraid of Ron Corvus.
The second shot, what a better opponent for this guy.
Well, I think Nathan's going to come in here with no fear whatsoever, but I think he's going to underestimate, which I'm sure he's not going to do, because Ron Corvus is a machine.
Yeah, there's two big guys going up against each other.
Yeah, it's two large men, so this is definitely going to be a battle of the big dogs, and you can expect madness tonight.
So, predictions.
You know, I'm actually going to go with Ron Corvus for
Ron
this one.
Ron Corvus.
I think he's brought that title to show that he's not here to play, and I think he could out wrestle Nathan Reynolds.
I mean, Nathan Reynolds is a very scary guy. But you know what? I really want to see what this new guy can do. Big Hungarian guy, you know? Absolute monster! Sorry, I think I've had about one too many parties. I'm absolutely buzzing tonight. I've been enjoying myself on commentary. You know how it be. You know how it is. It's always real when the real G is on commentary.
Have you been at the right pizza again?
Maybe a little bit extra.
Too much sugar, boy.
We told you to stay off the Ribena.
Mate, I'm always on that sugar.
Ron Corvus. I've never seen this guy before, but he looks like an absolute monster.
You could take him,
right? I don't know. I think I'd stay away from him, to be quite honest with you. But I have been in the ring with Nathan Reynolds many times, and I'd say I think I held my own. So I think my chances would be quite high against Ron Corvus.
I mean, I remember one time though, Nathan mangled you pretty bad.
He did. I've been mangled by Nathan many times. It's not a good feeling whatsoever. You wake up the next morning and your body's just in agony.
This one!
So messed up my arm.
And so, anyway, tell us about your injury while you're fighting tonight.
He just jumps on.
Didn't he like injure your hand at one point?
Yeah, it was my arm. From a double team something. And it's actually.
He's just relentless. Sorry to cut you off,
it's
dog.
No problem. It's just a little bit of a rotator back injury, but I should be back in no time.
Good stuff.
I mean,
speedy recovery, son.
I've been injured, that's why I've got this mark on my head, because I busted someone up last night.
Yeah.
I was on that party in Raid.
Yeah, that face is bad. You want to see the guy you beat up?
I'm about that life.
I wouldn't want to see the other guy.
About that life.
It's going to be like a Bessie's arm, the other one.
But no.
Even his mum won't recognise him. Yeah. But
Ron Corvus is outside taking a breather, but Nathan Reynolds is chasing him. Going to the other side.
Right off the barrier there! Whoa!
Just showing no respect, no mercy, just driving him off the ring post, the barriers, the apron, doing whatever he can.
I think Nathan's shown Ron Corvus that this is his house and he's just walked into the lion's den.
I mean, to be honest, I think this Ron Corvus is coming here expecting
the
Scottish wrestlers not to be up to scratch, you know.
Yeah, the crowd better watch out. They don't want just a really big guy flying right at them in the crowd, man.
Oh, Reynolds.
Right to the arm of Nathan Reynolds.
I need to stand up again. I can't see what's going on.
Stand up, boy, you are standing up. That's the third time you've done that gag, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah, it's getting a little bit old. Right. Everyone's going to go into each episode like, am I watching the same episode here?
No. We've still got the same clays on for a month.
I know. So the third weekend. We've just been sat here. But no, Ron Corvus goes back in. Big clothesline takes the monster down.
How much strength would that take, John? To get a clothesline like that.
Takes immense strength.
That's look insane.
He's just holding, big backbreaker.
Holding Nathan up, who's a big boy.
Just a one.
Just a one.
Just a one. And a big backbreaker like that.
Ron's going to have to throw everything he has at Nathan Reynolds, because Nathan Reynolds will not go down without a fight.
Man. Whips him off into the corner. Nathan just drives a forearm right onto him.
Nathan seems to be picking up a bit of momentum here.
Ron's looking a little bit tired. Oh, dodges out the way though.
I love the look of the new security. Guy with a wheelie hat on. Good security guy.
Oh, the mighty have fallen, eh?
Yeah.
Look at Ron Corvus just controlling Nathan Reynolds.
Oh,
just
punches to the head.
He's treating him like Nathan Reynolds is nothing. Oh, it's just disrespect from Ron Corvus. Ron Corvus going to try and pick up Nathan here, and he gets some. A back super.
The whole building moved there. Did you feel the building move?
The impact from that back suplex was indescribable. It was just so much weight coming down onto that ring.
If there's an earthquake on the news, you know why.
6.5 on the Richter scale.
I'm surprised the ring didn't move. Ron Corvus just whips him off.
That's incredible strength there. Incredible. But you know, Eddie, I think you could kick that Ron Corvus' ass. He's
like, I could.
Yeah.
Eddie, you could beat anyone in the SWE.
I'm a genetic freak.
You are a genetic freak. You may be a small man, but.
Oh boy. Hold on a second. Oh, man.
Nathan trying to pick up more
big
momentum here.
Suplex.
Nathan will be getting more and more angry the more this match goes on, and the more Ron Corbis is just destroying Nathan here.
Oh, neck breaker. Big neck breaker. But he doesn't go for the pin. Don't know if that was wise.
Nathan's calling for something here.
Picks him up.
I think he's going to try and put Ron away.
Big spine buster.
Big spine buster from Nathan Reynolds.
I think the ring moved a couple inches.
Oh, Ron kicking out just in the nick of time there. What does Jimmy, what do you think Nathan Reynolds has to do in this situation? He's been getting beat up for this match. What does he have to do now to
Nathan
to get back? Yeah, what do you think Nathan has to do?
Well, Nathan seems to have the momentum down, Ron.
Oh, Ron.
He's doing the right thing here.
Smart, that was smart move rolling up the ring, getting away from the danger.
I mean, that's what you would have done in that situation. If you were getting pounded, give yourself a breather.
Yeah,
he's almost he's hanging off. He's going to fall out. It's going to be like a tree falling down. He's going to be yelling timber soon. I mean, look at it.
Oh, Nathan swinging a miss.
Oh,
another big clothesline. Oh, what's wrong?
Whoa, hold on.
Whoa.
He can move as well.
I did not expect to see that from someone the size of Ron Corbis, but showing he's got the agility as well.
Amazing agility.
I'm surprised Nathan found a way to kick out.
Man, that was like a tree falling on top of him, man.
That was. That.
Talking about tree falling, it fell right on top of him. Oh!
Massive that's it,
done. No.
Oh, no.
Bring it off again. Another one. No.
What's wrong with him from here?
Whip him off.
Reverse from Nathan.
Ducks the clothesline. Big spinning heel kick! Wow!
That's got to be it.
And another kick out from Nathan.
You know what?
This man's fast. I like him. He can move.
I do like him.
Ron Corbis has got to be thinking, what do I have to do to put Nathan away? What do I have to do to keep him down to the count of three? And right now, we just cannot figure it out.
You know what, John? I think he's absolutely surprised at the quality that the standards of Reynolds. I mean, he's obviously came in here thinking I'm the big superstar from overseas.
You're right, you're tripping up on your own words a lot.
You are. Listen, you're a guest here, by the way. Okay.
Oh, he just blows up. Rocks him with the punches constantly. I don't know if they're closed fists. That's illegal. That is illegal. Just saying. Oh.
Oh, jeez.
Doesn't even. Okay, ref's counting. Nah, the crowd ain't counting.
Oh, no way!
See what happens when you play to the crowd?
Nathan's kicked out once again.
That's why the crowd only get you in trouble.
But the problem is, when you do things like that, you lose focus.
Exactly. He was looking towards the crowd, wanting them to chant with him. But they want. See, they're quick to turn their backs on you. They're sheep. The crowd. They're only responsible for losses. People say they help them win. No, crowd help you lose, homie. And that's the straight facts. That's the tea spilled.
That's just all.
Eddie, you know something? I think you've nailed it. You've absolutely nailed it. I don't know what you're talking about, but you nailed it.
Basically, the crowd ain't nothing.
Exactly.
Oh, big Ron Corbis is going to finish it. No, Nathan. Back body drop by Nathan Reynolds.
Nathan once again trying to get back into this match, but Nathan must be knackered.
Looking for that spear, I take it, to finish him off. Goes for it, takes him down, it's done.
It's
one.
It's got to be.
No!
Corbis is kicked.
Wow! No way!
Look at his face!
Nathan cannot believe it.
Hold up. How can you take a man running at you at that speed, and that weight, and that power, and still be standing? Well, I mean, he's not standing, but he kicked out. You know what I'm saying? This is ridiculous. Mad respect to Ron Corbis right now. Absolutely ridiculous, man.
Oh, sorry, man.
What was this? Taking him up, fireman's carry. Oh! That's a disqualification.
Ron Corbis taking the cheap way out and low blowing Nathan Reynolds.
Should have checked to see if the ref was looking, man.
Ron Corbis must have realised he could not have got the win.
Corbis doing? What happened there, guys? What happened?
What is Ron Corbis doing?
Corbis, did a low blow. Oh, he's got a chair up!
Oh, no! Steel chair!
He's going to hit the referee!
No!
Steel chair to the back of Nathan Reynolds!
World star!
Who's the better man, huh? Who's the better man?
Ron's obviously frustrated that he can't get the win.
He gets
coming back.
Oh, no!
Ron, get out of there. That's the smart move by Ron Corbis.
Going to break the damn ring. Almost, it almost bounced back and hit him in the pusher.
Ron clearly realised he couldn't pick up the win against Nathan.
This is double envy.
It is possible to commit no mistakes and still lose. That is not a weakness. That is life.
You're here right now at this moment because tomorrow you want to be somebody greater than the person you are today.
But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward.
If I'm gonna have any life in it, it's because I'm still willing to fight and die for that itch. Because that's what living is. The 6 inches in front of your face.
Jesus, I got a
city. Oh! Hey. It's done!
No way!
What a cheeky roll up! Like I said, I'm not.
Wow!
Oh,
who's this guy?
Who is this guy?
Why did you attack the very good Yoon Ji Maki this evening?
Why did I, Luther Lockhart, attack the very good Yoon Ji Maki? Let's just say I have a certain set of skills. An anonymous benefactor was able to front the hard capital. Invest in them. I'm barely legal. If Mackie is so bold and so stupid as a turn up, I got a message for you, buddy. I'll break your neck.
I don't know why he thought to attack E.G.
Well,
Mackie, but
he did explain. He said that someone hired him to put a hit on Maki, gave him the hard capital, he said, gave him the money that was required. You can see Luther Lockhart is some sort of hitman.
See, yeah, that's what it seems to be. But here comes the very good with Yoon Ji Maki with Brad Domico and oh, Dynamico's back with Atomico over his shoulder.
Dynamico wasn't at the last show.
He was not at the last show. He's been suffering with some knee injuries, but he seems to be back here tonight.
Atomico's just laid up. Why are they bringing out a dead body? Just saying. Why are they bringing out dead weight? That is literal dead weight that they are holding. That. Why? Why are they bringing him out? This is disrespectful.
This is not disrespect.
No, it's disrespectful to Atomico. He should be resting. He shouldn't be getting dragged out here. What is this? Oh, is he going for a little dance, is he?
AJ Mackey seems to be dancing here. Doing a little dance here tonight.
And Luther Lockhart does not look impressed.
He does not look impressed.
Well, he's shaking his head, saying, "Nah, come on. This is a wrestling match, not a dance."
But you, E.G. Mackey, is owning this dance floor here tonight.
It's not a dance floor, it's a wrestling ring.
Wherever E.G. Mackey is, it's a dance floor for him.
I guess all we need now is the pole, isn't it? I mean, is this match not happening? Is it just going to be dance? Is that what
this
it is?
This is pre-match warm-up, if you will, from EG Mackie.
Dude, he's just going to tire himself out. That's not smart. Oh,
EG Mackie does not get tired. He's got a Ferrari. He's a Ferrari. Just does not get tired. He's got a Ferrari engine in him. Lockhart seems to have the most disgusted look on his face right now. He seems to be not enjoying this at all. He must be very angry. That was fabulous from UNG Mackie, that was fabulous.
I'm just wanting to see the fight.
The crowd are absolutely loving EG Mackie right now.
No. You know what the biggest joke is? You are
EG Mackie is saying that he's disgusting for his actions last night.
Said he was getting paid for taking them out. Ewan is very angry.
Wouldn't you be angry if someone attacked you after your match?
Yeah, of course, mate. But I know you didn't watch the video, but Luther Lockhart said to Ewan Mackie that if he comes into the ring with him again, he'll break his neck.
Some strong words. But there's, I guarantee there's been more men that felt they could break the neck of Yuen Ji Mackie and not able to do it. Yuen Ji Mackie will never, ever go down without a fight. He may be small, but he will 100% be able to overcome Luther Lockhart.
Well, that dragon sleeper that we saw was very brutal, and it did look like it almost broke Yuen's neck, and that's what he'll be planning to do, but a double chop! Oh, a chop of his own. Mackie back with a chop. Oh, pushes him off the rope. Oh, can't take him down with a clothesline. He's just a big guy. The size difference is real here. Goes for a clothesline but ducks it. Oh, catches the crossbody.
Luther Lockhart showing his power early in this match.
Oh,
that's pure power from Luther here tonight.
Oh, man. Oh, just drives him into the corner. Oh, just ducks out the way. Goes on the top rope. What's he looking for?
Top rope, sleeping.
Oh, that was right across the face.
Straight to the face of Luther Lockhart.
Right on the pus, man.
Luther Lockhart just stomping on EG Mackie here, just using his brute power right now.
Got that foot right across the chest, showing him who's boss. Big forearm, just drags him across the ropes, into the corner, knee to the gut, just showing him who the dominant person is right now.
Luther Lockhart seems to be all over UNG Mackie right now in this stun.
Setting across the back, choking him with the ring rope.
Luther Lockhart seems to be working on the head, which is very smart strategy after what he done to UNG Mackie last night.
Yeah, the neck and the head area. Yeah, just for that dragon sleeper,
oh,
it seems.
Massive knee to UNG Mackie's gut.
Oh.
Double axe handle to the back, and another one
to the spine. The upper back, which is connected to that neck. You know, the neck area. That's what he's going for. So he can break his neck like he did in his promo.
big spinning heel kick from Yuji Maki.
Oh, big bulldog!
Using the ropes to his advantage here, taking down Luther Lockhart, but only for a second.
That's what you gotta do when you're a small guy, man. The size difference ain't
Luther
easy.
Luther Lockhart just with pure powers catching Yuji Maki.
Big! Oh, he went flying! Surely a world record somewhere.
That's a massive fall away slam.
Get that in the Guinness Book of Records, man.
What would the record be?
The furthest distance someone's been thrown.
I feel like someone would have thrown Australia for me.
It was pretty damn far.
It was.
One side of the ring to the other. One corner of the ring to the other. I mean,
just big stomps from Luther Lockhart.
Getting that foot right across the throat. Grinding it against his neck. Oh, a big uppercut.
Big uppercut from Luther Lockhart.
Just showing that he ain't messing around. He's going to break Mackie's neck and get paid. What was this? Gorilla press slap. Gorilla press drop, I should say.
That's just pure strength. The strength that Luther Lockhart has is just unbelievable.
And the luchadors trying to get the support behind Maki.
With this
but
C-chan.
It ain't working. Oh, it is working. Oh, no. Luther Lockhart is just saying no, telling all the crowd, shut up and just show what's happening.
Luther Lockhart
going
set
for
off
a big
suplex
here. Oh, the power! The strength! Oh! Bam!
Massive suplex from Luther
like
Lockhart.
A brain buster, that like landed on the upper back. I think it might have killed him. Dead, he's dead. Oh, there's the dragon sleeper.
Luther Lockhart set up for that dragon sleeper once again.
Oh, is he tapping? Is he going to tap?
So he gets to the rope. Oh, Luther dragging him back from the rope.
Is that a tap? That was a tap.
That was not a tap.
That was a tap.
You need glasses, sir.
I don't have my glasses on.
That was not a tap.
Hey, don't discriminate to people with bad eyesight.
Maki trying to get some offence here.
Oh,
dragging him back to the corner.
To the corner. Broke free of that hold. And he's raining those forearms down on Luther Lockhart. Bang!
Oh,
there's another
massive
one.
Forearm, but Luther's just shoving him away here. But
well, he needs to shove him away because he doesn't want to let him just continue that offense and gives
massive
a forearm. Says, job's almost done. Oh, there's another forearm.
Maki picking up some offense here against Luther Lockhart.
Get to the top
going
rope.
Going to the top rope. Cross
finally
body.
Finally gets that cross body that actually takes him down.
And a kick out
and almost
Luther.
Got the win, but it was only a two count. And a two count don't make you a winner. Breakfast launcher. Oh, the knee right to the gut. Takes him down.
Luther Lockhart is down here. Don't know what Maki is setting up here.
Says it's all done.
He says it is over.
Oh!
And he's going to follow it up.
Big splash.
Massive
one,
splash.
Two.
But Luther kicking out again at two.
Luther's looking tired though. I think this match is actually starting to take its toll on him. He's let Maki get on top of him too many times, too much offense, and he's just needing to stop that. Oh no, this isn't looking good.
This could all be.
Oh!
The man is scouted.
Oh, what is this? What is this?
What is Luther going for here? He's got Maki on the back.
Oh,
this is dangerous.
May as well call it. Oh, the torture rack.
The torture rack here.
Oh, it's a
neck breaker.
Oh, it's done! It's done!
It could be over!
Says it's finished!
Luther not pinning Maki, which could be a mistake. Seems to be gloating here.
Well, I mean, that was a very impressive torture rack into a neck breaker.
That was a very impressive move, but he should have went for the pin. So you had his match over and done.
Clinging to the rope like a koala bear on bamboo.
Oh. See, that's just disrespectful, trying to pin UNG Mackie with one arm.
Oh, there's the dragon sleeper
again. Putting the dragon sleeping on once again.
Almost tapped the first time. Look, will he tap this time?
Mackie
just
must
wrenching,
be in a lot of pain.
Wrenching back, making that neck bend at an awkward angle.
Mackie must be in a lot of pain after last night in his head and his neck. But he's fighting out with it. He's got a blocker. He's set him up.
It's done. It's done.
He's done.
I'm speechless.
Oh, but Luther Lockhart.
Wow.
With that.
The absolute determination of this man.
This freak can't beat me. It's too fucking little.
Oh, no. They're both exhausted here.
Both exhausted after this amazing match here. The crowd getting behind Mackie, trying to set it up. With Lockhart running towards.
Drop
kick to the.
I think we could both say we think that the end of the match is here because both superstars are just exhausted at this point. They've been putting each other through hell.
Lockhart,
big forearm. Oh no.
Putting UNG Mackie to the top rope.
Careful. This could be very big damage. It could lead to an injury.
What does Luther have in mind here? Putting him up top rope. Is he looking for a superplex?
Maybe he really is trying to break that neck of Mackie's. But Mackie just pushes him off. Mackie just pushes him off. Oh. Monkey flip.
Big monkey flip.
What is this? A pin? Cheeky pin. One, two. Mackie.
He's done it.
There we go.
Mackie has done it.
That's the second sneaky win that he has done in a row.
Winner, the very good Mr. Ewan G. Mackie.
I want that footage.
This man, Hugo Harris, he's came out showing what he's won. He's won that title and he wants to advance in this future division tournament.
Yo, come here, I'm coming,
my G, just you wait. So what's your predictions for this matchup? We obviously know the semi-final match.
Do you want me to be professional or do you want me to be real?
I want you to be real,
because
that's what I
real.
Expect from the real G.
Right. Not to be biased or anything, but I hope Hugo stomps him out.
is a fan favourite here in Spike Tierney. The fans are always behind this man.
Oh, there's your pal!
Oh no, we're not right, I was just about to say, I hope that Spike gets stomped out. Because if you remember, he's the one that eliminated me in the future division.
That's true.
And do you know there's a reason he wears a mask?
Because he's ugly.
Very ugly. His mother has a diet port chopper in his neck, so the dog will play with him.
See, if you look into the ring right now, you'd think Hugo Harris has a massive advantage because he clearly goes to the gym. But I wouldn't
just burying the man.
No, but if you look at that, Spike has the agility and he does mental things in that ring. So I think Hugo needs to watch out and not overlook Spike Tierney.
Here we go. He just stops him, says no. I see what you're doing. I know what you're like, Spike.
Spike's on the chase though for Hugo.
Mate, he could just keep running. Surely Spike will get tired. What? It's facts.
Now, this is the guy I had the money on.
Yeah, you know what? Nice that you said money because he's... Whoa!
Oh, what a kick.
I was going to say nice that you said money because he is part of Fortune 500. That team just screams money.
You know, Felix Fortune has actually got more money than Ted DiBiase.
Yeah?
Yep. That's true. He is a very wealthy man, and when you walk past him, you can just smell 50-pound notes. Just having complete control over Spike Tierney in this match.
Definitely got the upper hand here, John.
I'm surprised Spike is getting this much damage done to him because he's usually quite an offensive wrestler.
Yeah.
Big suplex! suplex from Hugo Harris, double H. Oh! Small package!
Spike. So, Eddie, what's your prediction for this match? And I'm guessing it's
Spike
Hugo
getting,
Harris.
Oh, Spike getting punched up. Spike is going to get punched up. Getting busted. Absolute busted up.
Do you know what I'd love to see? I'd love to see you interfering in the match.
No. No, because the man Hugo Harris, he don't need it, and plus I'm injured.
Yeah, but
I'm injured.
Okay.
So
you've got a wee cut on your forehead.
Mate, bottles were everywhere, man. Whoa!
Yeah, it was just crashing.
Spike with an elbow, spike with a boot straight to the face of Hugo Harris.
Goes up to the top
rope. Another boot. Hugo Harris is in the drop zone. Let's go for a
mission! Oh, Hugo, yeah!
Hugo Harris rolls out of the way. Spike crashed hard on the mat. The crowd can hear you.
Yeah.
It's brilliant.
Yeah, is there a problem?
There's not a problem. I'd love to be in a crowd watching wrestling and hear Eddie Devine in the background.
I should have a microphone so everyone could hear me.
You should.
Yeah, definitely, I agree.
Everyone deserves to hear the real G.
I mean, that would be so much more entertaining that people sitting in the crowd could hear us as well.
Yeah, well, I mean, they could hear me because I'll make sure I can be heard.
Yeah, okay. Right, Harris has got the upper hand here. Two count, kick out on the two by Spike Tierney.
Spike Tierney setting it up for the sleeve down Spike. Oh, but Hugo Harris going to reverse it.
Just gets sent right over. Let's blame Zach Leon for that, by the way.
See, you two have overlooked Spike, and you two think that he's going to get a thumping from Hugo Harris. But I think that Spike Tierney is one of the best.
Oh! He missed
what a dive!
Wait, did he miss him?
I think he got half his connection there, but I don't think he got all of it. I think Hugo Harris moved
last
second.
Dude was like a dolphin jumping through hoops, man.
A dolphin?
Yeah, man. No, I just dives like that.
I think Hugo Harris is seriously hurt here.
Hugo's struggling to get to his feet, but Spike
no
straight back
if you get
up
someone
to his
that
feet.
Weight, falling right at you.
Oh, what are you trying to say?
He's a fat little. Oh, gets punched. Oh, they're just trading punches
here. Punch here.
Forearm, those are legal.
Hugo's going to whip Spike. Spike ducks the clothesline.
Oh, with that clothesline of his own.
And there's another one. Oh, Spike's just rolling under. Drop kick to the back.
Oh, Hugo needs to get out of there.
Hugo is in a very dangerous position.
So 1-3-8-2.
1-3-8-2. Although you can see that Spike's getting a little bit tired here. From the intense fight that is going on right now. This is for the future division championship.
Spike's going up. Oh! What a kick! You heard that.
Just now, I just want to get this out of the way first.
Okay.
The future division championship. A high prestige title, right?
Yeah.
Jimmy thinks otherwise. He compared it to the Guru FC title.
Oh.
He thinks it's just for the rookies. Nah.
It says it in the national title, the belt is a future division title.
Still a big title.
It shouldn't go to a veteran wrestler, for example.
Oh.
Should be going to an up-and-coming wrestler.
Oh, here we go with a Boston Crab.
Hugo Harris could have it here. Hugo Harris could be advancing to the final of this future division tournament.
Going to break his back at this rate. Just putting all that weight on his back, but he's trying to crawl to the rope.
Can Spike make it to the rope?
Break!
Spike has made it!
But he's going to hold on.
Hugo is not letting go. There we go. Stick to the rules, Hugo.
Man, I'm out of sugar.
That's one too many Ribenas. Stop your Ribenas.
I find that ironic that Spike was in the Boston Crab there because he had an awful dose of the crabs.
Oh!
What a reversal from the powerbomb.
He's going
Spike
for
once again.
01382.
01382.
I just took a knee right into the face there.
Spike Tierney going up to the top rope.
Is this for the Swanton?
Is he thinking about Swanton? Yes, he is! Connected.
It's done.
What a maneuver!
That's got to be two.
Oh!
Hugo Harris kicking out just in the nick of time there.
And look at Spike, he doesn't know what to do now. He's like saying, I've thrown everything I can at him. Why won't he stay down? Look at him.
I mean, guys, I've never wrestled before, but how exhausted must they guys be?
Big mama bomb! And here's another Boston
Crab. He's flying tamer.
His back's done. His back must be done.
That's pressure on the neck as well. Spike Terry's tapping!
Done. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about!
Hugo's not letting go though.
That's what I'm talking about. Spike got stomped.
That's so much disappointment.
Yeah!
You must get some satisfaction out of that.
Absolutely. The man, and the best part is, it wasn't a pinfall. He had to say, I give up.
Yeah.
He had to admit that he couldn't go on anymore.
He could not handle
How does it feel, Spike? I know you're watching this back. How does it feel knowing that you've given up?
Well done, Hugo.
Well
done. So, ladies and gentlemen, that means that Hugo Harris is advancing to the final of the SWE Future Division Championship Tournament alongside Ken Caden.
You know
That's
what?
That's going to be some match.
Hugo's going to take it. I'm saying that now. Ha!
Bye-bye.
Na-na. Hey.
Goodbye.
Na-na-na. Hey. Goodbye.
See, you two can laugh, but it was an unbelievable effort there from Spike Tierney. I believe he gave it everything he's had, and I guarantee you that he will not be done with that title.
Satisfies me but your soul.
going to be happening here?
Well, as we heard, it's an open challenge for me and Ambrose, so I'm actually quite curious to see who's going to answer the call from the longest reigning SWE heavyweight champion of all time, Ian Ambrose.
Look at these shorts Ambrose is wearing.
Ambrose held the title for 400 days.
Oh, so it's not the longest reign.
Not.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's
my
bad.
But listen, this is no excuse for wearing shorts like that. Absolutely, it's got pussy cats on them, are we?
You call an Ambrose a pussy?
He's got pussies on his shorts.
So you're saying that he's covered in pussy?
Who's this guy?
Who is this guy?
I do believe that is Nate Stevenson.
Nate Stevenson has came straight out of SWE training school.
No, right. I just want to say this now. This man is wearing a man bun. That is trash. Man buns, get out of here.
Okay, what is that? I don't know.
Man bun is his hairstyle. Look at it.
All right.
Try to pretend he's some sort of samurai or something.
Yeah.
Nate Stevens has came straight out of the SWE training school.
Let's face it, you're in no position to comment on anybody's hairdos after that mullet.
What? Come on. You saying that my hairstyles have never been good?
It's nice now, but the mullet in the past.
What? Oh, wow! My mullet was fire!
Eddie, the mullet was shocking.
No, hey! My mullet was gold.
It was shocking.
I feel the arse is like achy, breaky hard, honestly.
You loved my mullet, don't lie.
I prefer this new do though. It's very
the gangster look.
You seem
like
more
it.
Like a G. Yeah. You seemed a bit more like
a
lassie.
Oh, look, see, he took the pussycats off.
Aye, well, that's a good. That's always something, isn't it? I mean, Ambrose come tonight in his pajamas. I can't believe it.
I don't think those were pajama shorts.
So they were pajamas. He told me backstage.
Rumour has it he's going to go home and go straight to bed after this match.
Yep, well, he's got his jammies already.
So, what do you think Nate Stevenson's chances are against Ian Ambrose here tonight?
Well, I mean, I don't know anything about Nate Stevenson, so
he's
really
a new
comment.
Trainee, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's a new trainee.
Is he really?
I've graduated
from the SW training school.
Is that right? Yeah. All right, okay.
I have trained with Nate a couple of times. I can say Ian Ambrose has to not sleep on him. If Ian Ambrose underestimates him for even 10 seconds, Nate Stevens will capitalise.
Really?
But here's the thing. You're forgetting that Ambrose is a franchise player. 400 days SW heavyweight champion.
But
364 days.
Eddie, at the end of the day, he's getting older.
Yes.
But 364 days, future division champion.
The bones are starting to creak and everything now. Right?
But
so
he was
older.
The last SWE tag champion.
But he is getting a bit old.
SWE was Grand Slam because he was also the now defunct Heartland champion.
I mean, do you know when Ian Ambrose was born, the old steeple was just a bag of cement.
But Nate Stevens is going to have the speed and the agility against Ian Ambrose, but Ian Ambrose will have the wrestling technicalities against Nate Stevenson.
But as I say, I don't know much about Nate Stevenson, but he looks the part, actually. But
well, I mean, for one thing, have you won against Ian Ambrose?
Yes, I have. It was a tag team match, and it was not nice. My chest was black and blue by the end.
What about one-on-one?
I've not been one-on-one, no, but...
you know who has beaten one-on-one?
You have, I believe.
Yes.
Really?
But I believe Ian Ambrose got a bit cocky and you sneaked your win.
Yeah, the back roll of death, man.
Yes.
Backslide of death.
I've not yet been one-on-one with Ian Ambrose, but I would like to be before...
Nate is just... Oh, Ambrose dodges. Trips him up.
See, this is where the wrestling technical ability comes in.
Single leg takedown.
Nate Stevens can do all the flashy stuff he wants, but at the end of the day, Ian Ambrose is going to be able to stop him with all this experience against him.
Right, Eddie, can I ask you something?
Yes.
See if you didn't have your shoulder injury.
Shoulder?
Is it the shoulder that's your head?
Yeah.
Right.
I mean, my shoulder's a little
bit... Would you have accepted as an open challenger?
possibly.
Me.
I mean, also my wrist is a bit sore. The main wrist. The main wrist. Yeah.
Have
yeah.
you been on that same website?
Yeah, I have actually.
The football one?
No, the keep fit one.
Oh, okay.
The Zumba one.
I mean, it's just like curling too many weights, my man.
Yeah.
Do you want to put your fit belt on? You get a lot of points. Put your fit belt on. Nate Stevens, Ambrose can't seem to roll out the ring. Nate Stevens is getting the upper hand here against Dean Ambrose.
Looking a bit tired already, though.
Yeah.
But this.
Oh,
this
look
is
at Ambrose!
This is the mistake.
Oh!
That's got the heart.
This is where Nate Stevenson has made his mistake. He's turned around, he's taken his eye off Ambrose, and that's where Ambrose will capitalize.
Oh, here we go.
Bang! Listen to them chops.
That's four chops now, that's four. I've been counting.
You can count.
Whoa!
That's five.
Welcome to the Red Hand Gang.
Two.
Hey, he's joined the Sunburn Gang.
Nate Stevenson rolling out the ring here. That's a smart move by Nate.
Mate, get those fans on his back, mate. Just
fan him down. What's Ambrose thinking about here?
Oh, no!
Oh! A beautiful uppercut
Very
by
clever.
Nate Stevenson.
Very clever.
Had Ambrose scouted.
Pure. Sure you can!
Whoa! Right against the barrier!
Nate Stevenson's taking advantage of the barriers here. And do you think he knows that he's not going to be able to beat Ian Ambrose one by one, so he has to use these scum tactics?
Would you look at Nate Stevenson's body, man? Honestly, it's like he's come out in a rash.
Nate Stevens is all over Ian Ambrose here. Nate Stevens.
Whoa!
Nate Stevens seems to have come out with a game plan and is executing that perfectly.
Good thing that isn't his main arm.
Somebody needs to call in.
Do you know what his main arm is?
Yeah, it's the right.
Oh, interesting. Nate Stevens, back, chest, everything's just red from Ambrose's strikes. I guarantee you he's thinking that this was a mistake.
Forearm. Another forearm.
But you've got to say, boys, you've got to say that takes a lot of bottle. That takes
that's
a lot
revenge.
Of bottle for a young up-and-coming wrestler to take on Ian Ambrose.
That's true.
I mean, would you do that in your debut?
I mean...
Well, my debut was against Darren Blair, so...
Really?
It was. My first match against Darren Blair, so you can see how I came out after that. I wear chicken wings. Leave, son.
Nate had him
scouted here. Nate knew what was coming here, so he tangled up Ambrose's legs and used the ropes to his advantage. Nate needs to watch that ref's count if he wants to make sure he can win this match. Just rubbing his chest.
Oh, wow, he's going for it.
Oh! This is all the revenge, man. This is the revenge. He's getting slapped up, man.
He's smacking him up.
Northern Lights suplex. Ambrose kicking out. I'm very impressed with Nate Stevenson here tonight. He is holding his own against Ian Ambrose,
definitely,
which I'm very surprised. I thought Ambrose would have finished this by now, but Nate has proven everybody wrong. So I guarantee there was everyone in this room tonight thought Nate Stevens would have got battered by Ian Ambrose.
Let's face it, he could be very proud of his performance and he could take a great deal of confidence going into his next match.
I think just having the confidence to challenge Ian Ambrose in the first place is phenomenal. This boy has got some serious guts.
That was my point, John. I mean, for his debut, he's taking on a legend in SWE. He might be a bit old, but...
He's old but still gold.
Old but gold, yes.
He's only 32.
Well, he's not old.
He's thin.
Yeah. See, Jimmy, you have my back. This is what I like about you. Eddie tries to take advantage of our mistakes and we're not having it.
Yeah. I mean, Eddie, that's
just because I have a lot of knowledge on Ian Ambrose.
I mean, Eddie...
That's because he was your best pal. You're his number one fan, Eddie.
Eddie, that's what I like about you.
What?
Nothing.
That wasn't very nice.
I know, sorry.
Yeah, you better apologize. would you like me to leave this commentary desk?
Yes. No, I wouldn't. I quite like you having you here. And John. I like John as well.
Oh, thank you, Jimmy. It's
oh, I thought you meant John Young.
Wow. No, John Gerf. Jesus.
Nah, you love John Young.
No, he's all right. He's been a constant disappointment to me.
Oh, Ian Ambrose, wind up!
Barriers!
Suicide dive from Ian Ambrose, and you...
What a maneuver!
Oi, my catchphrase, okay. I'll use that on special occasions. Anyway. What a maneuver!
What a wrestling move!
Ah, shit.
Mamma mia, suicida! Nate Stevens will be slowly figuring out what happens when you step to Ian Ambrose, and it's not a good feeling.
Oh man, his man's about to get punched up.
Eddie, you can tell me, because you've been one-on-one with Ian, how can you describe those strikes from Ian Ambrose?
Well, I mean, he kicked me in the back, and that hurt. It hurt.
Was it
because
it
was like someone kicked me in the back.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh no.
There she kicks.
Look at that.
Man's out like a light. Hey. Like a light.
Dude. Hey. Oh, Nate
like
Stevenson
a light.
Kicking hey. Out.
Through the flight. Hey.
How did he manage to kick out of there?
Because he... Oh man. Man took half a Zan 13 hours till he land. Had him out like a light. Hey. Like a light. Hey.
You have to say, if Nate Stevens had any idea... I guarantee you when he was in his training centre, he was looking up current wrestling, doing his homework.
I think he needs to comb his hair. He needs to comb his hair. Check his hair.
See?
That's what happens with
when
hard
you go for
work
a man bun.
Ring.
Man bun.
His man bun is coming out.
He's coming out?
I don't mean that out the closet. I mean,
Nate Stevens looks like Peter Pan after he went to the gym.
Oh, he's gone. Whoa!
Oh, he's flipped out of it!
Oh, I tried to hit him with a super kick, but you're forgetting that Ambrose is the king of super kicks.
I can agree with you there. There's no pain quite like a super kick
from Ian Ambrose. See, I know what you're going to say. That's because I'm next level. I can read people's minds.
Well, folks, I'm sitting here with the Ian Ambrose fan club here.
Hey.
Oh! Was that... Oh, a kick out from Nate Stevens there.
Wait, I heard three.
Nate Stevens got his shoulder up just in time there.
Oh, we all know what Ambrose is going to go for now.
Yes, we do.
That double stomp. And if he hits it, it's over.
Nate Stevens right in the drops. Nate Stevens going to move.
Straight to the knee.
Super kick straight to the knee of Ian Ambrose.
Ambrose will need a crutch.
Oh!
Okay, it's done.
Brutal knee to the face of Ian Ambrose.
It's done.
Nate Stevens going for the pin here. Does he have him?
Whoa!
Oh, Ian Ambrose has gone to the
one
ropes.
One finger on the ropes. One finger.
One finger.
Did you notice it was his middle finger? How cocky is that?
Well, I mean, the middle finger's the longest finger.
No, I suppose it.
I mean, it's like... I mean, look.
Okay,
get your hand
right,
out.
Okay,
get your hand out.
Okay.
You can see... The middle one is the longest.
That there just shows the
see? See? The longest.
Stop doing that.
Nate Stevens putting those well-educated feet to good use.
Oh, Hurricane Rana.
And a Hurricane Rana off the apron from Nate Stevens.
This guy is good.
This guy is very good. But he could not be Mighty Fine.
Oh, wait, I did that better in my match.
You did. I've seen you do that, and it is better than that.
John,
all respect to him, though.
Yeah.
I've even offered to manage him. I've got that much faith in Eddie Vine. It's not everybody I want to manage. I want to manage you.
If Eddie was on a betting website, I'd put my mum's house on it.
Let's not talk about websites.
Well, is that wrestling website? I mean.
No, the Keep Fit one.
The Zumba one.
The aerobics. Bedroom gymnastics.
Was that clear on there? Was that clear on there?
I don't know. I thought I knew his face was something.
Nate Stevens winding up. He's just mocking Ian Ambrose, going for that super kick. Is he going to connect?
Wow!
He connects!
Could you imagine?
Oh.
he wins.
But Ambrose is still on his feet.
Yo! Bro's Teaster bomb!
But another kick out from Nate Stevens. I mean, look at Nate Stevenson. He has kicked out with everything that Ian Ambrose has put towards him. And I've got to say, Nate Stevens has impressed me tonight, and I guarantee he's impressed every single one of
these fans in the
Adler Complex.
He just survived a Bro's Teaster bomb, and now, it's for the... Is this the womb stone?
No.
Oh, no.
Oh! Oh, did you hear that?
Nate
Stevens just snapped up Bro's fingers there.
And that is not good for him, because, he's mad now. Oh no!
Nate Stevens has caught him. He's going for a submission.
Oh!
Look at the twerk on Ambrose's arm.
He's not going to.
Is he going to give up? Is Ian Ambrose going to tap?
I don't think so.
Can Nate Stevenson beat Ian Ambrose in his SWE debut?
How much pain can he take?
Ambrose gets his foot again to the rope.
That is experience.
Ambrose knew what he had to do to get out with that move.
But you know what I was thinking, boys? I'm thinking, Nate Stevenson, what a performance from this young guy. That is testament to the SWE Wrestling School. From all the coaches, they've trained this guy.
Oh, he dodges the knee. Super kick of his own.
He's still on his feet. Walking like the curry man.
I think he's feeling a bit dizzy.
Well, you know, when Ambrose hits you with a super kick, your jaw is just gone.
It's done.
Frog splash for me and Ambrose.
That's it, over. But
Ian
well
Ambrose has beaten Nate Stevens in his SWE debut.
But well done, Nate Stevenson.
That's a massive. Well done. Nate Stevens came out here on his SWE debut and challenged Ian Ambrose, and he almost got that win. Huge respect to Nate Stevenson.
Definitely. The guy gave a great account of himself there.
There's not a lot of men that in their debut will challenge Ian Ambrose and almost win.
No chance.
That man can go home and be full of pride.
Yep, definitely.
Right, guys, give us a... That's going to do it this week. All that shite. And push the next Uprising event, which is April the 27th. Thank you.
Right, guys, thank you so much for tuning in this today.
Do you want me to take over? You alright?
No, I've got this.
Here we go.
Take two. Right, guys, thank you for tuning in to SWE Uprising. We will be back on the 27th of April. I got that. 27th of April. Thank you very much for joining us. We'll see you again next week. From me, Jimmy Young, Eddie Devine, the mighty fine Eddie Devine, and John Kerr. Good night, everybody.
Good night, guys.